So the next video, in this video we are going to discuss about the structure of spermatozoa or sperm. Children, this is the structure of spermatozoa or sperm. A mature sperm is about 0.06 millimeter in length and it is enveloped by plasma membrane. You see, this is the outermost layer, is the plasma membrane. And the sperm is divided into three main regions: the head, the middle piece, and the tail. Now, head is oval shaped, you see, it is oval shaped, formed of nucleus and acrosome. This is the nucleus, and here is the acrosome. Children, acrosome is formed by Golgi complex. If you remember Golgi bodies, I have often told my tell my children that Golgi are those organelles which behave like courier services. They are the ones which are responsible for packaging and dispatching of any material required by the cell. So acrosome is formed from the Golgi complex and it contains many lytic enzymes. You know what are lytic enzymes? The ones which are responsible for breaking through or for lysis. Children, behind the head is the neck. This is the neck. You see the small portion between head and middle piece is the neck. Then we come to the middle piece. Middle piece is composed of axial filament surrounded by mitochondria and cytoplasm. This is the axial filament in the center, the line you see, the axial filament. It starts from here, the axial filament, and this axial filament you see is surrounded by coiled structure which is the mitochondria, and cytoplasm is also filled up here. Now we all know that mitochondria are known as the powerhouse of the cell, so we can relate this thing with the motility of the sperm. Motility means that they can move, and for moving they need some energy which is provided by the mitochondria. So mitochondria produce energy for the sperm motility. Then comes the tail. Now children, the axial filament, it consists of central axial filament. If you see, the axial filament has started from here and this is being continued till the tail. You see, it is full in the tail and also coming out of it. So the sperm moves in fluid medium and female genital tract by undulating movement of the tail. This tail helps the sperm to move in further, and sperm needs to travel long distance because it has to travel from the testes first through the rated testes, epididymis, vas deferens, then it has to reach the penis, and then from the penis it has also to move into the vaginal tract and reach the fallopian tube to fuse with the egg. So this is the distance it has to cover. So this tail helps in the movement of the sperm. So this is about the structure of sperm. Children, the human male ejaculates about 200 to 300 million sperms during one coitus. Right, coitus means one intercourse. So at one coitus, a healthy male is producing or ejaculating 200 to 300 million sperms. For normal fertility, at least how will we come to know whether a person is producing proper amount of healthy sperms? For that, we say that a normal person or the normal fertility is at least 60% of these sperms. 60% of these sperms must have normal shape and size. And 40% of these 60% should show vigorous motility. They should show vigorous movement. If this is the situation, then we say that the person is normal infertility. But if this statistics is fluctuating or it is less than what we are asking for, then we say that the fertility is in question and the person should see the doctor. So again, I am repeating, children, for normal fertility, 60% of this produced or ejaculated sperms, 60% of them should have proper size, proper shape. And out of 60%, out of those 60%, 40% of them should have vigorous motility. Then only we say that the person is fertile. Right?